Peterman, who is the owner of the Comedy Playhouse and also a restaurateur. And he is going to be telling us and adding a little bit to the discussion that we've had already with Paul about how the restaurants and entertainment venues have been impacted by COVID and by these regulations. Tell us how you got involved with Paul and with the whole, you know, Revive restaurant.
We both have become, because we interviewed Paul, is it Paul? We interview Paul so often on the radio station that we have so much in common as far as being in the restaurant business and being frustrated. That in fact, I called him, we had him on the air, and I was so angry about what's going on just between counties that I actually apologized to him because I think I ruined his interview because I was so upset.
Yeah, I had a 5-minute segment. I think I spoke for maybe 30 seconds.
It was awesome. Yeah. It was really good.
We haven't discussed that, the difference between the counties, Niagara County being open and us not being. We haven't discussed that yet. How is that possible?
I don't understand. I really don't. And it's you can go down Transit Road, and this is what I was yelling about. And is this table's on? This won't flip, right? Because no. I'm going to get really upset
right,
here.
Right,
no,
right.
I won't go towards you. I'll throw it over towards the camera.
Okay.
You can go to Niagara County on Transit Road and go to almost any restaurant that normally would not have been overly busy. On a Tuesday night, you can't get in. It's at what my opinion is visibly 100% occupied, and yet you drive 5 minutes down the street and that business can't be open. I mean, it's not like COVID goes, oh, Maple just became Griner, let's stop. You know, I mean, it's what's good for one is good for the other, and it becomes an unfair battle for survival.
And I think what we're finding now, Rob, is that, you know, when they've had the holidays, And you know, we're remaining shutting down as a cluster, and you know, the idea was COVID cases would increase and so on and so forth. When you look at the two counties, being that even, you know, the CDC's regulations saying restaurants are an issue. But when you take the growth of COVID in those two regions, just taking Niagara County and Erie County, where COVID cases were pretty relevantly the same, right? They were almost the same. But what they're saying is restaurants are such a cause, but you're finding that in Erie County, cases are rising at a much rapid rate than Niagara County, which is what's 100% open. So if you can control an environment where we can have people come in this restaurant, we can control where they sit, how they sit, when they get up, that's what we are supposed to be doing. When you send somebody into their home, especially with Bills playoffs, where people are absolutely having home parties, which we're Buffalonians, you're going to do that. You're putting them in an environment that New York State has admitted that they cannot control and admitted that we have strict guidelines to follow, and they are punishing us, as you can see right now, multiple times for breaking the rules. So we are, you know, my buddy at Duff's, Greg, I mean, his statement is 100% correct. How about the fact that we are not part of the problem, but we're part of the solution? The solution is to get people into these controlled environments, 100% proven by Niagara County. They are way, way occupied. They've got all these regulations that they don't have to follow.
And I don't think the argument here is to say, hey, go down to Transit Road and close them.
Right.
No, the argument absolutely. Is to be able to say, yeah, they can open the door, we can
safely.
Open the door.
Correct.
And the other thing off of what Paul was saying, the frustration for me having a comedy club, I'm indoor entertainment. That's beyond just food and drink. So with that in mind, they told me that I could be open as long as I didn't charge an admission to get in. If I charged an admission, then I couldn't be open. So now I have no control over how many people are coming to the club because they can walk in and walk out and walk in and walk out, where I'm saying, let me charge them $10 and I'll seat half of the room, and they wouldn't let you do it.
Right. So the guideline on that is what? What's the restriction? I can have 100 people in here for free, but I can't charge them?
I can't charge 50 people to come in and make it safer. So
guess what you're really saying is, what's the logic? What's the reason
correct.
For it?
What's
well, that's why I'm on this show. Yeah. I thought you had the answers, Penny.
I'll tell you later.
That's exactly what I wanted.
You are. What about live entertainment? We were talking before about what's going to happen to the whole live entertainment industry. And that's another industry, besides the restaurant part, that is suffering. So many people are suffering economically.
I can't tell you what it's done. I'll give you an example. So stand-up comedy is like playing an instrument. You need to be doing it all the time. I normally will do about 30 to 40 shows because of my club a month. I have not done one show since February. So my instrument, so to speak, is completely out of whack. I have nowhere to be able to even work on my craft. So now as a comedy club owner, I'm going around trying to hire the comedians that used to come to my comedy club and just kill it. Well, they're going, I haven't performed, I'm too scared, I just got a job at such and such. And there are people that were on the verge of making it. And I mean, my best friend who does all the voices for the Transformers movie is, no joke, he took a job filling cannolis in an Italian restaurant in Los Angeles because he felt like he's just a year behind the eight ball.
And listen, we're not discounting the virus. We're not saying it's not out there. We're not saying this is not a hazard due to that virus. What we're saying is, in Rob's case and in my case and all restaurateurs, at proven through Niagara County even, is that we do it right. We spent a lot of money. We did exactly what the government wanted. We changed and adjusted for every rule and regulation that we want, and we're being punished for it, and I don't think that's right.
And we're not forcing anybody to come in.
That's correct.
If you feel so uncomfortable that coming into a certain environment makes you feel uncomfortable, you have the choice to not go in.
Right.
As long as everybody is in there doing what it's being told to do to protect those that are there, if you're uncomfortable, I understand, then when the time comes, come in. But
right.
But that doesn't mean you should close me down.
Thank you so much, Rob.
Absolutely,
Penny. For joining us and for being so hysterically funny. And thank you so much, Paul.
We're
going to continue this story, and we're going to watch the progress of it, and we're going to have further information. So please stay tuned.
I've been honored today to work with Kelly from Gabriel's Gate, a longtime company in this area. It's in the Allentown area. So tell us a little bit about Gabriel's Gate, how long you guys have been here, and just the start from you to this point.
Okay, so we've been here for 20 years, going on 21 actually, so a while now.
Right.
It's definitely a second home for us. The building itself, or the restaurant itself, has been here since 1969, and we took it over 20 years ago. We have, I believe, possibly 100% of our staff is actually full-time and has been here for,
wow.
Yeah, we really get people who come and they stay. And that, you know, like I said before, helps show that they're invested in the restaurant as much as we're invested in it. The initial shutdown was a trying time for everybody, right? It was just a lot of questions and question marks and non-answers that we all had. And unfortunately, we as business owners weren't able to provide many answers to our staff, which didn't help make anybody feel, you know, great at the end of the day. But I have to say that they really hung in there with us, and we got through it. We reopened briefly.
Right.
And there was some light at the end of that tunnel. Obviously, you know, that ended a little bit in November, but we're hoping to get back into it.
So in this case, what we're trying to do is, you know, through Revive West New York Restaurants, we're obviously trying to have, this week be Gabriel's Gate's Restaurant Week. It's to go. It's not the normal routine. We know that. We're asking for everybody to congregate to one restaurant for 1 week, as many people as we can get. We've got some sponsors out there. We've got US Foods, which is going to be helping them get through some food for this week, helping towards the purchases. We've got Johnston Paper Company. They're going to be the ones donating a little bit of money towards what they're doing. And then we have multiple other donors that'll help. But we need your support. We need people not only to come here, we need them to go to revivewestnewyorkrestaurants.org and donate. $19.27 is really trying to be our average donation. That's the year my grandfather started Santora's in the Western New York area, who has given us so many years of support. So now we're asking that you support everybody we're affiliated with and make sure they're taken care of. So we have come up with a couple of specials for this week, and Kelly's going to go over those.
So for specials, we are going to do a full dinner. So it'll be a crock of French onion soup, which we're also pretty well known for. Half a rack of ribs that'll come with a choice of French fries, rice, or baked potato. And that will also come with a piece of our homemade cheesecake, and that'll be the $19.27 price. And then we have two sandwiches, a Buffalo Avenue sandwich with lettuce and tomato, hot sauce, blue cheese, that's served with French fries, and a female bacon sandwich with lettuce, tomato, American cheese, that is on a roll, and that is also served with French fries, and both of those will be for $10 each.
Thanks to Paul Santora from Santora's Pizza Pub and Grill, the folks at Gabriel's Gate in Buffalo, and everyone involved in Revive Western New York Restaurants. We will continue to follow how this project is going in the coming weeks. I'm Judge Penny Wolfgang. Thanks for watching The Big Picture. Thanks for watching WBBZ-TV. And remember to support hometown, locally owned businesses.